I am Dr. Chandrika Shekhar, working as an obstetrician and gynecologist in Chirag Hospital, JP Nagar, second phase, Bangalore. And I am also a visiting consultant visiting Malti Manipal Hospital, Jayanagar 9th block, Apollo Cradle Hospital, Jayanagar 5th block. I also do occasionally visit Madhurhood Hospital, which is in Banashankari 2nd stage. Coming to intrauterine insemination, you have asked the causes of intrauterine insemination. The term intrauterine insemination means that you are promoting the fertility of the individual. This is done in patients with infertility. It is one of the basic infertility procedures that we do in individuals. This is when the patient is not getting pregnant, we try to facilitate the lady to become pregnant by doing this procedure called as intrauterine insemination. This is done in situations wherein there is slight weakness of the male factor. That is, there is some small factor with the male, that is semen. That is the one which we facilitate the insemination. That is, we deposit the semen which has been treated in the laboratory and made more viable. And that semen, we take it and under sterile precaution, we insert it into the uterus. So semen is deposited into the uterus so that the egg that comes through the fallopian tubes and enter the uterus, that semen, that is the sperm, will travel through the uterine end of the fallopian tube and enters into the tube. And the egg comes from this side, and usually both the egg and the sperm meet in the fallopian tube and they come and get deposited or settled in the uterine cavity. That is the procedure of intrauterine insemination. So it is done in cases of infertility. So there is no symptom of that one. That is the thing that we are doing. So we naturally deposit the semen inside so that the pregnancy can happen, and we try to give supportive measures like hormone supplementation, etc., to prevent the abortion and for her to continue her pregnancy to term. There is no special symptom for intrauterine insemination because we are just facilitating the pregnancy to happen, and if she becomes pregnant, then whatever pregnancy symptoms that any lady can have in early pregnancy, those are the symptoms that the patient can have. So the early symptoms that can happen in pregnancies, one is some people may have giddiness, some people may have nausea, some people may have vomiting, and some people may have generalized weakness. These are the routine symptoms. If the IUI failure has happened, it means that she has not conceived. So there is no precautions in that case. Only if the IUI has been successful, that means she has conceived. So we have to take all measures for her not to abort. So that time we try to recommend her to be in rest, and sometimes we put extra medicines to prevent abortions. That is a thing. And when IUI failure happens, then we have to plan what next we can do. What is the routine thing I want to tell is, in IUI failure, we can always attempt once again. So you may ask how many times a patient can repeat IUI procedure. So usually this IUI procedure can be repeated about 5 to 6 times. And there is no meaning in continuously repeating, because it is not correct to repeat more than 5 to 6 times. And if she is failing to conceive even after 5 to 6 attempts of intrauterine insemination, it is better than she consults her infertility specialist and they will go to a different procedure which assures her more chances of conceiving. That is the thing I want to tell you about IUI.